Hello, dear friends, how are you? So, today it's Sunday, tomorrow evening, Monday evening, and Tuesday, it's this unique holiday called Purim. We're talking about spiritual holiday. It's not like a, you know, it's a holiday for the soul. Every person can celebrate this holiday because it's a day that the Creator shares so much happiness with all humanity. Actually, Purim, it's the source of happiness for the entire coming year. And that's why I would like to do a special prayer and meditation, all of us together, so we can actually prepare our consciousness for the great light of Purim, and as a result, draw that great light with us for the entire coming year. So, you know, first of all, before we start the meditation, I'd like to remind what we already spoke about, that happiness is basically the light of God. God is endless happiness. And all what God wants is to share his endless happiness with all humanity, with all every human being in the world. We learn in Kabbalah that if you want to connect to the endless happiness of God, how do you do that on a practical level? How do you connect to the endless happiness of God? All what we want in life is happiness. What really people are looking for is to be happy, to really be happy. How do we connect with that? How do we get the ability to really connect with endless happiness? So the Kabbalah is teaching us, if you behave like God, you can connect with God. How God behaves, God constantly wants to share endless happiness with everyone. That's what God is busy with. And when our agenda, when we're thinking, when our focus is, how can I share endless happiness with humanity? I become similar to the Creator, and as a result, I become unified with the Creator, which, as we said, the light for us of God is the light of happiness. So I become unified with the endless light of happiness. And Purim, on the holiday of Purim, we actually receive that energy to be able to share happiness with all humanity for the entire coming year. As we're doing this prayer, as we're doing this meditation, we're already affecting happiness to the world. So we would like to see ourselves, we can close our eyes, to see ourselves in the Holy Temple in Jerusalem. The Holy Temple in Jerusalem is basically an energy center to share the endless energy of happiness with all humanity. We really see and visualize how we're sharing light of happiness with every human being in the world. Say a prayer a few times and you're welcome to repeat after me. Dear God, please help me to help every human being in the world to be happy. I'll say it again. Dear God, please help me to help the entire world to be happy. I'll say it again. Dear God, please help me to share endless happiness with the world. We visualize how much endless happiness we share with the world. We are happy to share. It makes us happy. It makes us calm and relaxed and balanced. We see how the energy that we share awake every human being in the world, awake them to connect with the endless energy of happiness, to be awakened also to desire to share endless happiness with the world. We visualize how the entire world, all the people in the world, that's their focus, that's their energy. All what they want is just to share endless happiness with the world. When people in the world are focused, their singular focus is to share endless happiness with everyone else, then people are not busy with their own sorrow and misery and emptiness and lack and sadness, because they are so focused to make everyone else happy. So they don't have the time and the focus to focus on their lack. So it helps people to get out of their sadness, misery, loneliness, and all the rest of the root of all problems of life. By doing that, we're changing the energy of all humanity. We're elevating all humanity to a higher frequency. Frequency of Messiah. Through the unity and the love and the sharing of happiness between us, we're becoming oneness, unified with the Creator. We bring so much joy to God, because the joy of God is when we're sharing happiness with each other endlessly. And then God can become unified with us. The endless energy of God, the endless energy of happiness can become unified with us. We're meditating to connect to the light of Purim. Purim is a day, 24 hours, that it's the source of all happiness. Meditating that we're preparing ourselves to receive the great light of Purim. We see ourselves that during the entire day of Purim, our focus will be sharing endless love, endless happiness with the world. Our focus will be to receive endless strength from God. So throughout the entire coming year, we will be busy with sharing endless happiness with the world. We visualize how Purim will give us the strength, and we see ourselves how throughout the entire coming year, every moment and every day, we will share happiness with great joy. We will do it with so much joy to just share happiness with everyone. Not like I need to do it, but I'm happy to do it. It's my merit. It's such a pleasure to share happiness with everyone. It's bringing me closer to God. I'm so happy that I have the merit to be part in that. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to read a section from the Zohar. That every letter that we will read from Sifra, that's Tzniuta, the concealed book, will meditate that the light of that word, that letter of the Zohar, is shining happiness to all the people in the world. מי ובוזה יקלו, דאו מן דלא ידע, נחדה שמה קדישה ולקשרה קישרה דמהמנותה, ולמשך על אתר דהצטריך ולהוקיר שמה דמערה, תב דלא דלא התברה. כל שכן מן דלא התכוון באמין, ולדה כל מן דמרחיש בשפתה בניקיותה דליבה, במיה דמנקה מקטיב בעדה ויום אלוהים לעשה אדם, כלומר, בשביל אדם דידע להחדה צלם ודמות כדכיות, וירדו מדגת הים. ויאמר לו ינשא אדם ואדם לא כתיב, אלא אדם סתם, אבקה אדם דלילה, תביד ושמע שלים, כדי שתלים דה, שתלים דה, שתלים דך ונקבה, שלמה כולה. סדרה דתך אלוהים, סדרה דנוקבה, התפשט חורה, התקיין ותקונות, כגעמה, מפומי דעמה מלכין, התפתלו אחר מתקיימו. דינין קורה, התקפים ברישה, וסופן נכין, דנוקבה ביבקה. התקיע קונטירין, דקיתורה, ותפוריש, כי אין יוד זהירה, והשתקח. We're going to say soon the Anabekoach prayer, but before that, I'd like to share with everyone. Every month of Pisces, which is the month prior to the new cycle of life, starts with the month of Aries. I have like a special book that I'm writing names of people. The names that I'm taking, Kabbalah says that on Purim, you can connect every soul to the source of happiness for the coming year. So I am creating a list of names, and on the day of Purim I'm praying for everyone, but not just on the day of Purim, every month in the beginning of each month this coming year I'm praying through the list. And when I'm going to visit the graves of the tzaddikim and the righteous, and also every Saturday afternoon in the third meal, which is special opening. So, if you like, you're welcome to send me. I'll be happy that you'll send me names of people in your family, close people, either family or close people to you. Write the names, and if you want, you can write near every person something to pray for them that can help them to be more happy, can help them to overcome their loneliness or emptiness. It's very important that we'll do that, that we'll pray for the people. You can send me the names. And also, if there's something in the world, this is very important for you to pray for, to heal that place, situation in the world, a place in the world, also send me. You can send me either in an email or in a WhatsApp or in a, you know, Facebook Messenger, also option. Also, I have a Google voice number. You can use that as well. And also, one more thing. Kabbalah says that on Purim, it's an important thing to give charity. Either the days before Purim or on Purim. In the charity, we're meditating all the names that you want to write. Meditating that energy of charity, which is energy of mercy, that brings mercy to our movie, to our karma, into the world, is the power of charity. We're connecting all those souls to the energy of mercy and letting go of energy of judgment. So it's also an option. And also, on the day of Purim, what we do, we're collecting money, and we go on the day of Purim and give it to poor families, to really poor families, and we make them happy, because the Kabbalah says that if you're making people happy on the day of Purim, we should make everyone happy on the day of Purim, but especially people that really don't have food, and food will make them happy. It's a very important thing. It brings a lot of happiness to the entire world and to your karma as well, and to the Creator. So if you want, either you can do it by yourself. If you don't have the option to do that, you can transfer to me the money, and we'll make sure to give the money to the families that needs that on the day of Purim. And now I would like all of us to do the Ani B'Koach together, and we'll pray. Every day, every word that we sing with the Ani B'Koach, it's releasing great energy and basically help all humanity to awake deep happiness within them. Let's say the Ani B'Koach together. Ani B'Koach Gidulat Yeminecha Tutir Tzorah. Mekabel Rinat Anecha Sagevenu Taharenu Nora Nagibor Dorshe Yehudecha Kevavat Shomrem Barchen Taharem Rachamei Tzidkatecha Tamin Gomlem Chasin Kadosh Berov Tuvcha Na'il adatecha Yachid ge'e Le'amecha p'ene Zochrei kedushatecha Shavateinu kabel Ushemat tzakatenu Yodea ta'alumot One more thing I would like all of us to do now. I'd like us to scan together the 72 names of God. The 72 names of God, basically, it's unique names that give us the ability to awake energy of happiness within us and throughout to all humanity. That's why we're scanning the letters line after line, from right to left, and then the next line, right to left, etc. And as we're doing it, we're really meditating to connect every soul, every human being, to the energy of happiness. Welcome to do it together with me. If you don't have the names, you can just open it on Google, just type 72 names of God. We're scanning it from right to left and top to bottom, injecting strength into the holiday of Purim, injecting strength for the coming year, that every moment of my life I'll be busy with sharing happiness with the world, sharing happiness and joy with the Creator, and forgetting and letting go of being busy with my own loneliness and emptiness. Knowing that as long as I'm sharing happiness with others and focus on helping others to be happy, my loneliness, my emptiness will be filled by the endless light of God, the endless happiness of God, and I'll be truly happy. So I have nothing to worry about. I can trust that I'll be happy. I'll be happy, and that's the most important thing. What's our part? To help others to be happy. If I'm doing my part, then God will do his part. I can trust it. I'd like to pray and wish every one of you and me and all of us praying for you for the most important thing in life. I'm praying for you that the Creator will give you strength to help everyone in the world to be happy. As long as that's our prayer and that's our focus, we're in the right place in life. We'll have everything that we need. So I'm praying for you. May the Creator will give you strength to help every human being to be happy. I would like to wish every one of you happy Purim, meaningful Purim, in success of all Purim, that every minute of Purim, you'll be able to strengthen yourself with energy of happiness and strengthen the world with energy of happiness. Chag Sameach, happy Purim.